In this video, we're applying the propagation of error to measurements of a heavy disk. So given the measurement of mass with uncertainty and the radius with uncertainty, we're going to compute the moment of inertia of this disk with the uncertainty properly computed using propagation of errors formulas. So the mass of the disk is given to us in grams as 2,742 grams plus or minus 1 gram. But what we're going for the units of moment of inertia are kilogram meters squared. So we need to get this into SI units. And I just have to shift the decimal place 3 times. So this mass is 2.742 plus or minus 0.001 kilograms. The radius measurement has a similar issue. It's given to us in centimeters. And we've got to convert that to meters. So this time we shift our decimal place twice and I get 0.178 plus or minus 0.002 meters. And we're given the formula for the moment of inertia of a heavy disk as 1/2 mr². So in part A, we're going to compute that moment of inertia. And then in part B, we apply the propagation of error to get the uncertainty. So we just plug in m and we have 1/2 times 2.742. We plug in r, that's 0.178. And don't forget to square that. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 0.0434. I'll keep a little extra precision. There's an extra 4 there. Kilogram meters squared. Now part B is the real meat of the problem. We want to get the uncertainty in this moment of inertia by using propagation of error. And because moment of inertia is proportional to this measured quantity, the mass, and then the square of the radius, our propagation of errors formula looks like this. And note that there's an extra factor of 2 in the radius term there. That's because it had an exponent of 2 in the moment of inertia formula. Now, interestingly, we could plug in delta m and m in the original units of grams, and we'd still get the right answer. And that's because all we do to convert to kilograms is multiply it by a factor of 1/1000 in the numerator and the denominator there. So those factors of 1000 cancel. It's also possible to plug in the numbers in kilograms, and that would be fine. But I think it's a little cleaner to just use our original units of grams. So I have 1/2742, and we're squaring that. And then our delta r will just do the same thing. We use the original units of centimeters. Because those occur in a ratio here, it doesn't matter. So there's 2 times delta r over r, and we have to square that whole thing. And when we run the numbers on this, we get about 0.0225. Now what we just computed was the relative uncertainty in the moment of inertia. That's the uncertainty divided by the moment of inertia itself. And we still need to solve for the uncertainty in the moment of inertia. So we have to multiply both sides by I. So I take my 0.0225 and I multiply it by my original moment of inertia computed in part A, 0.04344. That has a lot of extra precision in it. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 0.000977. Now my usual convention is to round the actual uncertainty to one significant digit. So this is going to round to 0.001. In other words, there's a small amount of uncertainty in the thousandths place. And then to state our final answer, that's I plus or minus delta I, we go ahead and round the original moment of inertia to the same decimal place addressed by the uncertainty. So that's the thousandths place. So I get 0.043 and then plus or minus 0.001 kilogram meters squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.